guys, JC here. I wanted to share with you this portrait I did recently of a sweet bulldog named Boris, who's 1 year old. So usually I start with a wet and wet wash here, and I try to make the background very indistinct and the colors bleeding together, and really just bring out some light and dark integrate the dog into and show off his best features. Here I'm using a little brush by Rosemary & Co. to integrate the dog and soften the edges of his coat. Then I start with some very pale golden colors, like this is a Naples yellow. And I put that everywhere where the dog is going to have warm tones. Here and there you can see that I have put, like in the shadows under his legs and his feet, some of the green from the background. Then I just go in with some warmer tones, probably burnt sienna, a very, very light wash here and there, and some pink undercoat for the paint, not the dog. This kind of dog doesn't have an undercoat, because there's a lot of pink in a dog's white fur. That's the skin showing through. So here I'm just modeling the form of the dog. He's got a lot of folds, and some parts are shiny and some parts are deep. So modeling all of that with several layers of watercolor pigment. I go in with some sepia to bring out the deeper parts of the dog's fur pattern, and do the muzzle. So muzzle has to be so subtly handled, just because it's a delicate part of the dog, the hairs, the nose, I don't want it to be looking too harsh or have the folds too deep, but we do have to show them. So the bulldog's nose, of course, is pretty special. It's got a lot of crevices and a certain kind of shine. And the eyes, of course, dropping in the personality of the dog. Getting the pink of the tongue in. I used a quinacridone rose for the tongue, also some permanent rose from Winsor Newton. The shadows in there with some indenthrone blue, which is a color I just love. And of course on the lower lip, there's some bounce color of green from the grass below, reflected in his shiny lip. Finally, now I'm using a rigger to put some tiny little white hairs in, just to soften everything up, and of course the whiskers on his chin and on his cheeks with some titanium white gouache. So that's it. I've met this dog. I know this dog quite well. He's so sweet. Oh my gosh, it's been a real joy to paint him. Thanks for watching.